The bearing characteristic number in a hydrodynamic bearing depends upon. So let's see what is bearing characteristic number of a hydrodynamic bearing. So we have a graph of coefficient of friction versus bearing characteristic number, that is Zn upon P. So it is also denoted by C, sometimes alpha, sometimes K, and that C is equal to Zn upon P, or also Z velocity upon P, where Z is viscosity, N is speed in RPM, and P is load and velocity. So that concludes bearing characteristic number depends upon viscosity, speed and load. So coming to given options, length, width and load, that is wrong. Length, width and speed, that is also wrong. Viscosity, speed and load, that is option C is correct option. Option D, viscosity, speed, bearing pressure, that is also wrong option. Consider the following statements. Radius of friction circle for a journal bearing depend upon. So the question is about radius of friction circle. Coefficient of friction, radius of the journal, angular speed of the rotation of the shaft. Which of the statements given above are correct? So here, radius of friction circle, that is Rf equal to mu into R, that you can see here. The dotted line circle is called as radius of friction circle, and it will depend on coefficient of friction mu, and then R, radius of journal, the radius of journal. So therefore, radius of friction circle for a journal bearing depend upon mu into R, that is coefficient of friction and radius of journal, and it doesn't depend on angular speed of rotation of shaft. Therefore, here 1 and 2 are correct. So that concludes only 1 and 2. That is option B is correct option. In a journal bearing, the radius of friction circle increases with the increase in load, radius of the journal, speed of the journal and viscosity of the lubricant. So we know radius of friction circle Rf equal to mu into R. So Rf will increase with the increase in mu and R. So as per the given questions, load is not a correct option. Radius of the journal is the correct option. Speed of the journal, there is no speed parameter in it, that means C is wrong. And viscosity of the lubricant, so that is also wrong. So that concludes option B is correct option. Which of the following bearing is suitable for the application where large radial loads at very high speed? So large radial load and high speed application, which of these bearings are used? So here option A, rolling contact bearing or ball bearing. The ball bearings are not used for large radial loads. So for medium load, we can use the rolling contact bearing. but for large radial loads, these are not suitable. Coming to sliding contact bearing, the sliding contact bearing are nothing but journal bearings or bush bearings, and these are used when large radial loads at very high speed is required. That means B is correct. We can see the journal bearing here. It is seen from the curve that there is minimum value of coefficient of friction mu for a particular value of bearing characteristic number denoted by alpha. What is this value of the bearing characteristic number? So the question is about bearing characteristic number and the coefficient of friction mu. So when we see the graph, mu and bearing characteristic number, there is a minimum value at which the coefficient of friction is also low and bearing characteristic number is also low. So they are asking, what is this K is? So this K is called bearing modulus. So the bearing should not be operated at bearing modulus. Since the slight decrease in speed or slight increase in pressure will make the part of shaft or axle that rests on the bearing operate in a partially lubricated state, resulting in high friction, heating and wear. So at this K value, it is most avoided to operate the bearing. So at this value, there is very partial lubrication. So that result friction and heating and wear. So therefore, the bearing characteristic number is prevented by changing the value like 3C. So that will come somewhere here. This is 3C. So here the bearing is safe for operation. So even for larger fluctuation or heavy impact loads, it may go up to 15C somewhere here. So that ensures the safety of bearing. So the term is bearing modulus. That is option C is correct option. What is the main advantage of hydrodynamic bearing over roller bearing? So here the question is, main advantage of hydrodynamic bearing over the roller bearing. So the given options are easy to assemble, relatively low price, super load carrying capacity at higher speed, less friction. So when we see the roller bearing and hydrodynamic bearing, the super load carrying capacity at higher speed is the main advantage of hydrodynamic bearing over the roller bearing, because there is no possibility to carry the heavy loads on the roller bearing, but it is possible through hydrodynamic bearing. So therefore, option C is correct option. Which of the following sets of parameters should be monitored for determining the safe operation of journal bearing? So the parameters for safe operation of journal bearing is the question. So the given options are oil pressure, bearing metal temperature and bearing vibration. Bearing vibration, oil pressure, speed of shaft, bearing metal temperature and oil pressure and bearing vibration. So for the safe operation of journal bearing, oil pressure, bearing metal temperature and bearing vibration are the key factors. So that concludes option A, oil pressure, bearing metal temperature and bearing vibration is the correct answer. If k equal to 3 for ball bearing and k equal to 3.3 for roller bearing, which one of the following correctly states load P life L relationship for roller contact bearing? So we have four options. The relationship between dynamic load carrying capacity C and the equivalent dynamic load P and bearing life L in million revolutions is given by L equal to C upon P raised to K, where K is equal to 3 for ball bearing and 3.3 for roller bearing. So by this, we can conclude that option C is correct option. Deep groove ball bearing are used for. So the question is about use of deep groove ball bearing. Heavy thrust load only, small angular displacement of shaft, radial load at high speed, combined thrust and radial loads at high speed. So this is the deep groove ball bearing, and this is suitable for high and very high speeds, accommodate radial loads. So that concludes option C is correct option. A journal bearing of diameter 25 cm and length 40 cm carries a load of 150 kN. The average bearing pressure is, so we have to calculate the average bearing pressure. So we have average bearing pressure is equal to load upon projected area. So that is, load is 150 kN and projected area is 25 into 40, that is diameter into length of the bearing. So that gives 0.15 kN per centimeter square. So therefore, we have no option, that is 0.15 kN per centimeter square. So that concludes, none of the above is the correct option. Which one of the curves shown below represent the characteristic of hydrodynamically lubricated journal bearing? So they had given one figure and with some curves on it. So they are asking, out of these four curves, which curve represents the characteristics of hydrodynamically lubricated journal bearing? So we know the coefficient of friction and bearing characteristics curve drawn, that is curve number 3, represent the characteristics of hydrodynamically lubricated journal bearing. So that concludes option C, that is curve number 3 is the correct option. Match the list 1 bearings with list 2 application and select the correct answer using the codes given below. So we have bearings on the list 1 and its application on the list 2. We have to match this. Journal bearing. So journal bearing is used in marine engineering. Thrust bearing, it is used in swiveling chairs. Conical pivot bearing, it is used in watches. And ball bearing, it is used in electric motors, that is 3, 4, 2, 1. Therefore option C is correct option. Which one of the following is criteria in design of hydrodynamic journal bearing? समर पिल नंबर, रेटिंग लाइफ, स्पेसिफिक डायनामिक कैपेसिटी, रोटेशन फैक्टर. सो हियर द क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट क्राइटेरियन इन डिजाइन ऑफ हाइड्रोडायनामिक जर्नल पेयरिंग. सो वी हैव समर फील नंबर दैट इज एस इक्वल टू आर अपॉन सी स्क्वेर इंटू म्यू वन अपॉन पी. ऑन दिस क्राइटेरिया हाइड्रोडायनामिक जर्नल पेयरिंग इज डिजाइंड. सो दैट कंक्लूड्स ऑप्शन ए इज करेक्ट ऑप्शन. मैच द लिस्ट वन विथ टाइप ऑफ एंटी फ्रिक्शन बेरिंग विथ लिस्ट टू स्पेसिफिक क्यूज. सो वी हैव एंटी फ्रिक्शन बेरिंग ऑन द लिस्ट वन एंड स्पेसिफिक क्यूज ऑन द लिस्ट टू एंड सेलेक्ट द करेक्ट आंसर यूजिंग द कोड गिवन बिलो. सो हियर लिस्ट वन ए इज सेल्फ अलाइन बॉल बेरिंग. So we can see self-aligned ball bearing. So we have options. So it will match with pure hinged condition. A matches with 2. Taper roller bearing. So we have taper roller bearing. And this will match with pure radial. That means B matches with 3. And then deep groove ball bearing. So we have deep groove ball bearing. And this is for axial and radial loads. That means C matches with 4. And then thrust ball bearing. We can see this is the thrust ball bearing where we apply the thrust loads, and this will match with pure axial load. So that concludes 2, 3, 4, 1 is the correct match. Taper roller bearing can take radial load only, axial load only, both radial and axial load. And the ratio of these being less than unity. And option D is both radial and axial load. And the ratio of these being greater than unity. So this is the taper roller bearing. It can take both radial and axial loads. That means we have a shaft here. We can put the axial loads on the axis of shaft. This is axial load. And when we go along the radius and put the load, these are called radial load. So this taper roller bearing can take both axial as well as radial loads. And then the ratio of radial load to the axial load is greater than unity for a taper roller bearing. So that concludes option D, both radial and axial load, and the ratio of these being greater than unity. D is correct. Which of the following is correct? A hydrodynamic slider bearing, that is journal bearing, develop load capacity mainly because of slider velocity, wedge shape oil film, oil compressibility, oil viscosity. So they are asking about load capacity of a hydrodynamic slider bearing, that is journal bearing. So here the hydrodynamic bearings, it will develop the load capacity due to the wedge shaped oil film. That is option B that you can see here. That means option B is correct option. So here we have assertion A, that is, in steady rotating condition, the journal inside a hydrodynamic journal bearing remains floating on the oil film. So let's look on the assertion first. So they are telling about after start, that is steady rotating condition. So at steady rotating condition, the journal is floating, that you can see the oil is here or lubricant is here and the journal is floating, this is bearing. So that means assertion A is correct. Coming to reason R, the hydrodynamic pressure developed in steady rotating condition in journal bearing balances the load on the journal. So the hydrodynamic pressure developed. So due to its rotation, the hydrodynamic pressure will be developed and it is steady rotating condition and it balances the load on the journal. That is true. Due to this rotation, it will balance the load on the journal. So that means reason R is also correct. Coming to given options, both A and R are true. Yes, assertion A is also true and reason R is also true. And R is the correct explanation of A. So R is the correct explanation of A. That is correct.